Josiah, any chance you can give up for the people that are uninitiated a little bit of a primer on Slambovia?
On Slambovia itself?
Yeah, where, you know, where and where not Slambovia might exist.
I think I'm too much in Slambovia to like pull that together somehow. But Tink will say something to you.
Okay, not everybody knows this, but the original coining of the term came because we were recording an album in New York City. And we just came up with this, you know, there was a sense that sometimes, and I'm sure you all experience, sometimes the things you do, you're not physically capable of doing things, but things happen, kind of metaphysical. If you're a tennis player or a gymnast, there's this metaphysical realm that's beyond logic that kicks in and you're in the zone. So even musically that can happen. So it can either be you're in the zone or people are helping you from the zone. It's kind of like this open space. So it's really, so.
And we were in the zone because we were doing that out, this is a long time ago. We were doing an album with Eddie Kramer, you know, who did all the Hendrix stuff and a lot of Zeppelin stuff. So Eddie heard some stuff that we did and he came to record for us.
So the stuff that really kind of touched the zone, we felt like it was really like helped by the zone or by the people in the zone. We called them the people of Slambovia that helped us. We give them a credit on the album. But we said that the song was, wow, that is Slambovian. Instead of saying slamming, we said, no, this is Slambovian. So then it was a realm that we kind of coined and we kind of tapped and we kind of like thought there were really people there helping us from that realm. So then that was like,
I'm gonna give us some medication for it.
So then
I'm gonna grab it for a minute.
We disappeared and then a few years later in the woods of Sleepy Hollow, New York.
Yeah. In other words, a lot when we finished that album with Eddie Kramer, everybody wanted to sign us. Everybody. And we split New York City and vanished. None of our friends knew where we went. And we stopped playing for 2 years. Her and I went into the woods, and then I was in the graveyard in Sleepy Hollow, and all of a sudden this like a vision. I have a lot of visions, and you know, see a lot of visual spirit world stuff all the time, which people always tell me I should take medication for. But all of a sudden this, you know, Gandalf, the whole thing was Gandalf, Murphy, and the Slambovian Circus of Dreams popped into my head. And I went and I told the band that we had just gotten together with a drummer from a community college that we started with, and I said we should start a band called Gandalf Murphy and the Slambovian Circus of Dreams, and that was the beginning of all our folk fame and fortune.
And the people here, like, but also it extends to,
chased all the labels away.
but the Slambovian experience, it's like when you come to a show, so it's not like what's happening on the stage. It's like that even the word circus means circle. So it's like the circle, it's the Slambovian circle at the shows. That's the Slambovian.
See, she's like LSD, right?
So it's that, you know, if the show is good, it's because of us.
Oh, yeah.
It's us.
Yeah, because this show tonight could have absolutely sucked. If we were home playing this in our living room and we recorded it, it would have sucked. But because you guys dug it, and a lot of people were very appreciative on the break. I don't think they were stroking us. A lot of people had like a different kind of experience with us instead of in the wham bam band that we played. So we hope you had a really good time. We had fun. We had fun playing. Walk on from Alabama with a banjo on my neck, and I'm bound for Louisiana, I'm true enough for to say. Oh, it rained all night the day I left, the weather was bone dry, the sun so hot I froze. Yeah, we don't have a slide, I forgot a slide.
Slambovia.